Oak Bay, Gordon Head.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. I move that a bill entitled University Amendment Act 2017, of which notice has been given, be introduced and read a first time now.
Honorable members, you've heard the question. All those in favour?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is carried. Member.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. It gives me great pleasure to be introducing a bill termed the University Amendment Act. Universities in the province of British Columbia serve a key role in an economy that is increasingly driven by knowledge, information and ideas. Academic freedom is a fundamental tenet for a culture of learning to succeed, and a key part of academic freedom is found in the right to participate in the university's governance. While the role of a board of governor is essential in a university, the governance of a university must also be independent. It is with this in mind that I bring this bill forward today. This bill amends the University Act to ensure that appointees from the Lieutenant Governor and Council cannot unilaterally set the tone and direction of a university board through having a majority of votes, and that university boards cannot unilaterally appoint a chancellor for the university. This Act, Honourable Speaker, also amends the University Act to change the composition, not the powers, of the Senate for special teaching purpose universities. The current composition of the Senate in special teaching purpose special purpose teaching universities can potentially give the administration of these universities the majority vote. This harms the ability of the Senate to keep the academic autonomy of the university at arm's length from government. This bill will bring British Columbia to the same university governance standards employed by much of the rest of Canada. I move that the bill be placed on the orders of the day for second reading at the next sitting of the House after today.
Honourable members, you've heard the question. All those in favour?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is carried.